UFC 165, it's coming up Saturday night, Air Canada Centre in Toronto, headlined by defending light heavyweight champion John Jones. He takes on Alexander Gustafsson. Joining us right now, manager to the stars, including John Jones, Malky Kawa with us. And welcome back to Toronto, Malky.
Thank you guys for having me. Wonderful city.
Always a busy time for you. Looking ahead to this Saturday night, we just heard the news, Gatorade coming on board as a sponsor now for John Jones. I'm sure something you have been dealing with for quite some time. Just tell us a bit about this deal and the continual push of John Jones with a lot of these blue chip companies.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we really honestly believe that John Jones is the number one fighter in the world, and we think he's one of the best guys out there to represent these big blue chip companies. So it's just been something that we've been working on for a while. And, you know, obviously John has been working on it even before he met me. If you notice that, you know, he got the Gatorade bottle sitting right by his belt, had it at the press conferences. It was something that he's always, you know, tried to get, and we knew it was a goal of his when we signed on with John. So it was just something we've just been pushing forward to, and his hard work, dedication, and great fights, exciting fights that he puts on is what helped make it happen.
What are some of the things that come to mind? You know, you must get so many offers across the table when it comes to attaching John Jones' name to a brand and what John Jones is comfortable with. What's kind of that process like? Do you sit down with John and something that you're comfortable moving forward with and pitch it to John? How does that dynamic work
You know, John actually is a very goal-oriented person, so he lays out all the stuff he wants. And so my job is to go out there and try to make that happen and obviously make the most amount of money for everything that he would like to do. We also get a couple times where we get some phone calls or some other marketing that we do as a company as a whole. And when we do that, we get a lot of offers from different places also as well. So what happens is that if you look at some of the other sponsors John has, you know, he signed on with Monster Headphones. Monster's number one in the headphone space. They're the ones who created Beats by Dr. Dre before they sold it off. You look at Everlast, been around for 100 years. You considered the probably most recognizable, you know, equipment brand in the world. You know what I mean? Sponsored every major fighter since Muhammad Ali, Mike Tyson, the whole nine yards now, John Jones. You look at Muscle Tech, a Toronto-based or a Canada-based company, who's the largest, nutrition company in the world. Those are the type of companies we want to align ourselves, the biggest and the best that we possibly can, the ones who are going to market John, the ones who are going to do, you know, what a big company is supposed to do, and then in turn we'll do what we're supposed to do and hopefully get them, you know, the exposure. And then again, you got to also understand all these deals that we have are all deals that are real. They're not just, you know, hey, they're paying us the most money. These are deals, companies that John actually, he loves Gatorade, loves Nike, loves Muscle Tech, uses Everlast in training. He uses his Monster headphones. You know, they're on him all the time. So, I mean, it's a natural fit.
What most speaks to advertisers when it comes to John Jones? I mean, he has a chance this weekend to break Tito Ortiz's record. He has, you know, without, no one really counts that Matt Hamill loss. He's the closest we have to an undefeated champion right now in the UFC. What really speaks to advertisers when it comes to John Jones and his unique ability to cross over into these areas a lot of other fighters can't get to?
I think if you look at just John as a whole, look how professional he is, how professional he looks, how honest he is. He looks like an athlete, talks like an athlete, goes out and performs like a top athlete. And I think that's when these big brands want to be aligned with the best in the business. And John's gone out and done that. He's proved he's the best in this business. So at the end of the day, as long as John continues to win fights and proves that he's the best, you know what I mean? Something I've been preaching since day one, that he's the pound-for-pound best fighter in the world. I've been saying this for 2 years now. You know what I mean? I think the companies are realizing it. You know, you have a 6'4", 205-pound monster in the octagon, and then a 6'4", 205-pound gentleman outside the octagon. And I think that's what these big companies are looking for.
You look ahead to this Saturday night, and Alexander Gustafsson is in the challenger spot this Saturday. You obviously want to put your fighter in the position to make the most money off of pay-per-view, but right now we see such a big disparity right now from John Jones on top to those next challengers. Is it almost presenting John Jones as he is the draw in and of himself at this point, regardless of the challenger? Tell us a bit about that, because there's just that big disparity factor, I think, for a lot of people.
I think when you look at just the fight game in general, usually your biggest and best guys are supposed to be the draw. And then when you have somebody who can come and possibly challenge for that belt, it makes it that much more interesting. I think Alexander Gustafsson is a very viable opponent. I think he's a good fighter, and I think it should be a very interesting fight on Saturday. And if that's how the world sees it, I mean, I'm not necessarily agreeing with that. I just think that I do believe John is a draw. I do believe that John is a draw in and of himself. And I think if you add, you know, someone else that could be a draw, you have a bigger fight. Mm-hmm. And if you just, you know, have somebody that you might not consider, you know, a big opponent or a big name opponent, then John might just, you know, be carrying the card by himself. I think that, you know, you can make a case for it, but, you know, I don't want to, you know, no disrespect to any opponent. I just think that John has become that guy.
Yes.
And this is really what it is. And, you know, I'm not angry, Joe.
Two quick updates I just want to get. Frank Mir, how quickly did he just want to bounce back into things after the Josh Barnett fight?
Right.
He's got Alistair over him,
right,
and
away.
He was just...
Right away. He was pissed off about that early stoppage. We all were. So...
How do you feel about pairing him with Alistair Overeem? He's obviously a very, very polarizing figure right now. Is this pretty much must-win here for Frank?
I think it's a must-win for both guys, which makes this fight that much more interesting.
And Benson Henderson, what is the latest on him? It sounds like he's not going to need any surgery. What timetable is he on?
He's rehabbing the elbow right now. It had, you know, had some damage to it, but thank God it wasn't anything where he needed some surgery. We're looking at possibly a February return.
And my last question, I don't even know if you can answer it, but all things go well on Saturday night, is Super Bowl weekend a target for Jon Jones?
You know, a good question. We haven't even thought about it. Like I told you guys every single time, we don't look forward past the next opponent. I kind of do. I kind of map this whole thing out in my head. Let me see what's the next big card or whatever. Who's the next big opponent? But I don't talk about it with John or anybody until after the fight. And, you know, me and John will always sit down and figure out what the next thing is. Depending on how this fight goes, he'll tell me if he wants some, you know, a lot of time off, little time off. Maybe you might want to bounce back in. Hell, they might want to put him on the December 28th card and then have him get on there with those guys. Who knows? I mean, it's just anything can happen with John. So, you know, we'll know. Right now, I don't know. I got no clue.
Malki Kao, one of the busiest men in the business, UFC 165. It's coming up this Saturday night, 10 Eastern. Jon Jones, Alexander Gustafsson for the UFC light heavyweight title.